Right, I wasn't sure whether or not to make this video because it's not really tech, but it could be a bit of fun. So I thought, yeah, all right, I'll give it a go. So yeah, we're doing a cocktail shaker, as you probably already know by the video description. This costs around about £13, so it's not expensive. And if you like cocktails, especially gin cocktails, I like gin cocktails, you might want to buy one of these. We're going to do a little experiment today. I'm just going to use some ingredients I've already got out. These little babies here, some lemon and some lime, tonic water, just a plain tonic water, and obviously a bit of gin. And some ice, of course. Yeah, don't forget the ice. We need the ice. So yeah, I've never actually used a cocktail shaker before, so it could be very interesting. The other thing I liked about this one is it has recipes on there for you and it shows you what to mix in your cocktail. So I thought that's quite good actually. So what we're going to do is I'm going to do a bit of an unboxing. I'm going to show you how it all works, hopefully, if all works out well, because I haven't opened it yet. And then we're going to make a cocktail, right? So with that, let's get on with it, shall we? So let's quickly do the unboxing then, shall we? Nothing really to look around, just see a picture of the, you know, the actual product and some information down the side, mirror polishing and all that. So we have a stirrer. And the actual device itself. Get all that out of the way. Oh, it's a little cup, a measuring cup. Oh, it's a seal in there as well. Right, that must be a spare one. So like I said, I've never used one of these before, so it's a bit of a learning curve for me as well as for you, but... Oh, it's got a dent on it. Oh, look, mine's got a dent on it. Oh, no, it ain't. It's part of the pattern. Like I said, I've never used one of these before, and I thought, oh, it's got a dent on it, but it hasn't. So that turns, see that? So if you want to make a martini, yeah, so it says two and a half ounce of gin, half ounce of dry vermouth, and ice. Cool, very good. Garnish olive or lemon twist. That's it. That's really good. So that's how that works. So you just turn this. So what's that? Cosmopolitan drink, margarita. Oh, you do a Tom Cruise drink, do you? So you just line them up with the arrow. And that is 1¼ ounce of dry gin, 1 ounce of lemon or lime juice, 1 teaspoon of sweet and sour mix. Don't know what that is. And you've got here 1 splash of club soda, ice, and garnish sliced orange. That's really good. I quite like that. I don't know if you can see that properly because it's a bit shiny and quite hard to read. But very nice. What's that? Mojito? Mojito, Mieta, Manhattan. Oh, I might make a Manhattan. What else we've got? Whiskey sour. I've got no whiskey in the house. I don't like whiskey. And back to martini. So I've got a good selection. What's the Manhattan to? 2 ounces of rye whiskey. Rye whiskey. Oh, it's whiskey. So I can't do whiskey. Okay, give that a miss. 1/2 ounce of sweet vermouth. Can't do whiskey, I'm sorry. Is that a whiskey? Oh, that's a rum. So that one's a rum. First impressions, yeah, very clever. I like the way they've done that. Margarita, what's a margarita? Tequila, I've got no tequila. 1/2 ounce of triple sec, is that secco? And 1 ounce of lime juice. We are actually gonna make our own. We're not actually gonna make theirs. Can you see that inside? Yeah. So you get a spare seal. I'm taking it as a spare one because there's one already on there. Oh, that comes off. And a filter. That's good. So I'm going to put that to one side. You get a little spoon for stirring it up. It's quite quite nice. Let's stand up. Well, it does. And a little measuring jug. I'm taking it as a measuring jug. Oh, it's two different sizes. Does it say anything on the side? No. Right. So I'm taking it as for the gin. Well, actually, that might be. I hate to keep saying this, but I've never used one before. So let me know if I'm doing it wrong or not. Or can you actually do it wrong? So with that, let's get on with it. So to start with, I'm going to add some gin. This is just cheap gin. It's not expensive or nothing like that. So just going to do a measure. Well, should I do that one? I'll do that one, actually. I'll do a small measure. So a small measure of gin. Got that. Pour that in. That was easy enough. Nice little kit, innit? I mean, it's only, what, £13 or something. So it's not expensive. And I thought, well, £13? So I'm going to do a bit of tonic water. This is just normal, cheap tonic water. Not expensive or anything like that. I'm going to do 2 measures of this on a large size. 1, 2. So that's that. Is that done? And I'm going to add some of my own ingredients that, well, they're not actually mine, that I actually bought just to make this video. Come on, come out. Chuck that in. Well, they're a bit stuck. There you go. I'm going to put 3 of these little seeds in. Okay. Cock it up. Some flour powder. I'm not going to tell you what they are because I took the labels off. So you might be able to tell me what these are. Oops. Touch of this. Oh, not too much, not too much. Got a nice smell to them though, like a perfume. And chuck one of them in. I'll tell you what this one is because I left the label on this one. This is citrus and synesis? I don't know. Sounds like a mouthful to me. Chuck that in. Chuck a bit of this in if it comes out. That's it. A bit stuck in there. There you go. Chuck a little bit of that in. And one more. Now I've used these before in another cocktail that I used to make cocktails. But they weren't a lot of cop, but it all adds to the hopefully to the experience. And the flavour. Chuck a couple of them in. And I'm going to chuck in a lime. I'm going to squeeze it first. Yeah, then chuck it in. I'm keeping the other one. And a bit of lemon. And some ice. Yes. Let's get the ice out. Done a video on this ice box, by the way, some time ago. Chuck a few of these in. Can. How we doing? Want some more? Want some more? And a couple more. 2 more. Do 2 more. 1, 2. Job done. Move that out of the way and give it a little stir. It's stirred, not shaken. Give that a little stir up and then we're going to give it a bit of a shake because we want to know if it's going to leak. Hopefully it won't because it's got this seal on it. Push that down. Yeah, that looks sealed. Is it going to leak? No. Now, I did watch a video on how to hold one of these. Oh, that did leak. Make sure you got the lid on properly. Oops, and I made a mess. Is that going to leak in? Have I got to hold it like that? Right, the top's leaking, which I wasn't expecting. Get a clean hanky out. Oh, it is clean, by the way. definitely clean. So that should be sealed, shouldn't it? Huh? Or is that leaking down now? Try it again. Ah, that's better. I didn't have the lid on properly, so it must have been that or that. It got hold it. Oh, that is really cold. And hopefully, he says, that should be it. So that should be ready. So let's find out. Smells all right. Ideally, you'd want another filter, a smaller filter, but oh, actually, that's not bad. Let's give it a little bit of lemon, then actually I'm going to pour some more out. So some of my smaller bits have got in. Wipe the glass round, like so. Like that. That is not bad. I wasn't expecting it to be that nice. Well, I'm making it up, so I wasn't expecting it to be that nice. But, so far, plonk that in. Plonk in some ice. Dash of lemon, dash of lime, a bit more of the drink. Job done. So that, my friends, is how I make a cocktail. Well, it is now anyway. So what I'm going to do now is let you have a quick look at it, and then I'm going to try out the drink properly. Back in a second. Indeed, it's got smooth, got a bit of a bite to it with the lemon. You can definitely taste the lemon in there, and obviously the gin. So it definitely gets my thumbs up. I've never used one of these before, like I actually said right at the beginning, I've never used one of these, but I like the idea that you've actually got different cocktails that you can make, and it actually tells you what ingredients you need, and I thought it was a brilliant idea. And I like the fact you get these little measuring cups, or two different sizes. Again, I thought was very good, and a little stirrer. Yeah, very nice, well made. And I did think, oh, got some dents in it. Oh, that's no good, got dents in it, but it hasn't. Very good, very impressed. definitely gets my thumbs up, considering how much they cost, or this cost, is about £13. And don't forget, I will stick a link in the video description in case you want to go and check it out. And it's a great way to make a cocktail. And I might have invented a new drink. So if you've got any ideas what to call this drink, something like, I don't know, Yorkies cocktail special, I don't know, just making one up. Come up with an idea, come up with a unique gin and tonic for my channel. So with that, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down, and please subscribe. Thank you very much for watching. I'm going to enjoy me gin and tonic now.